NFL players may not have the longest careers, but for the years that they are active, they make a lot of money. So it's no surprise that some of them have the most lavish houses, and we're here to show you the most expensive mansions of NFL legends. Randy Moss, $749,000. The legendary NFL wide receiver decided to sell his home in Lincoln with a 40% reduction from the price he paid in 2008. But someone like him can easily sell an estate and buy a new one. After all, his net worth is around $25 million. Now, before we look at what he bought next, let's take a look at the house he sold. This 3,846 square foot contemporary home is spread over 4 acres. With 3 bedrooms, 3 bathrooms, and hard flooring, we imagine it would have been hard to say goodbye to this beauty. The master bathroom has not one, but 2 separate vanities, a walk-up hot tub, and a walk-in shower. Seems like there's a lot of walking in this bathroom. Now, the bathrooms might be fancy and modern, but the kitchen is somewhat traditional, but with elegance. It has wood cabinets and glass doors, which gives it a very homey look. And if you look outside, you can see a charming New England-style gazebo and a bar near a huge pool. Looks like this place was perfect for summer parties. Now, the NFL star lives in Charlotte, North Carolina. However, it seems like he values his privacy a lot because the specifications of his recent house that he has owned since 2014 seem to be unknown or confidential. Rob Gronkowski, $1.6 million. On the field, Mr. Rob is a beast, one of the best tight ends in history. But off the field, he's a heavy party guy. However, he's not like other celebrities who spent millions on pretentious properties. Instead, Rob Gronkowski, aka Gronk, buys a place where he can bust out a beer pong table at any time. His party house has always been lively and fun. With 4 bedrooms and 7 bathrooms, this 3-story home is perfect for a day off. Moreover, it also has a 3-car garage, a hot tub, which is a necessity these days, and a game room, as well as an outdoor shower. However, all good things come to an end, and so did Rob's ties with this house. He purchased this house back in 2012 for about $1.6 million, and then he put it on the market for about $2.4 million, double the price. It is located in Tampa Bay. The house even boasts an elevator, a media room, and obviously, well, a wet bar. Terrell Owens, $2 million. Terrell's home was built back in 2001, and it's a lot more than you would expect. It is 9,100 square feet, contains 6 bedrooms, 8 bathrooms, and a master suite and his and her baths. And we're not even done yet. It also has a 2-story great room, a gourmet kitchen, a dining room, a formal dining room, whereas we just sit down on our bed and have dinner anytime we want, and the list just goes on and on. This could very well be the reason why Jamie Foxx and even R. Kelly were former residents and owners of this house. This house really is a tiny city crammed under one roof. Now, if you want to relax, there is a full spa available, or you can just go to the cabana and enjoy the white sand beach along the lakefront. This house is easily worth $2 million, and the renovations cost another $1 million per seller. Whoever built this house really hit the sweet spot. Unfortunately, Terrell Owens had to sell the beauty, and ever since then, it has been available and all open to the market. Richard Sherman, $2.31 million. After signing a large extension with the Seattle Seahawks, Mr. Richard was lucky enough to be able to afford this huge, stunning mansion worth $2.31 million. The surprising part is that the Seattle area mansion actually belonged to Jamal Crawford, a cornerback for the Seahawks. Even though Crawford bought the estate for almost $3 million, Sherman got a good deal on it. But just looking at the living room, you can tell by the high ceilings that Sherman spent money on the right thing. The 9,435 square foot house has lots of cool features, including a game room. It even comes with an indoor pool and a hot tub. It's only reasonable that the estate has a huge basketball court, as Crawford played in the NBA. Now, if you thought that was all, you would be very wrong. The place also has a private deck for every bedroom. And other than that, it has a personal beauty salon, 2 stone fireplaces, and obviously a mandatory security system with cameras. Robert Griffin III, $2.5 million. RG3, back in 2012, the Washington Redskins quarterback, made a big decision. He decided to splurge $2.5 million on a home in the Virginia suburbs. Back then, he was a budding superstar quarterback, and a $2.5 million price tag was quite expensive for him. The house itself has 5 bedrooms and the same amount of bathrooms, but that's not all in a 9,000 square foot home. There are a lot more exciting things going on here. It has a wet bar, a gourmet kitchen, a game room, and a wine cellar. You don't see many of these often now, do you? Griffin's place is about 30 miles outside of Washington and is actually a part of a gated community that has a Jack Nicklaus golf course. Well, when you buy an estate in a place like this, it's only obvious that you have to have millions of dollars for all of the different amenities. Unlike many other houses, there's nothing too flashy or ostentatious about this house, much like the man's personality. It does have a lot of antique furniture in the foyer and in the overall interior design, but it gives a nice touch and feel to the house. The kitchen is furnished with beautiful black countertops and a big bright golden lamp hanging from the ceiling. It also has a painting room, antique cabinetry, and a spacious backyard. Peyton Manning, $4.5 million. The Denver Broncos quarterback Peyton Manning settled in the Cherry Hills Village and bought a house worth $4.5 million in 2011. Now, this isn't a big purchase for someone who earns almost $18 million a year, but what could this huge mansion have in store? Let's take a look. The 16,464 square foot area covered about 7 bedrooms and 10 bathrooms. The two-story Georgian estate has a beautiful driveway with an oversized severe car heated garage so that snow does not accumulate anywhere. Pretty fancy, isn't it? The ground floor is a safe room and a separate media and billiards room. And that's not even remotely all of it. There's also an attached dog room with an indoor and outdoor heated kennel. But our personal favorite is their kitchen, decorated with granite countertops and a walk-in pantry. And no kitchen is complete without a formal dining room and a butler's pantry. The master suite is a dream come true. With his and her walk-in closets and cherry wood built in, it is understandable why the NFL player paid so much for all of this. Now, one surprising thing is that there is no pool, which is quite unusual for such a huge mansion. But with such a spacious veranda and patio, he could easily get one. Tom Brady, $17 million. What happens when you mix a model and an NFL player? Well, you get Tom Brady. His looks might be impressive, but his new mansion is much more impressive. Tom Brady just paid a whopping $17 million for a huge new mansion. While all of us were socially distancing, Tom Brady bought an estate on the exclusive high-security Miami Island. Because, well, what better way to social distance? Tom and his wife Gisele Bündchen plan to actually demolish the house that they have right now and build a much better and eco-friendly one. They are both keen on designing their house. In fact, they are even fanatical about their doorknobs. The Indian Creek Island only has about 30 homes, and only the richest of the richest can afford such a luxury. It is protected by a private 13-person police force at the center of the island. You also have an 18-hole golf course. Pretty crazy, right? The couple purchased in December of this year, and a week prior to that, Ivanka Trump and her husband Jared Kushner paid about double the price they did for an empty lot. The interesting thing is Brady is actually friends with Donald Trump himself, but their relationship became uncomfortable after he ran for office. According to him, political support is totally different than the support of a friend. That is a wrap for expensive mansions of NFL legends. Which one of these did you like the most? Let us know in the comments down below. Make sure to give the video a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel for similar content. See you in the next one.